Gather round while I sing you a Wernher Von Braun, a man whose allegiance is ruled by expedience. Call him a Nazi, he won't even frown. Nazi schmazi, says Wernher Von Braun. Don't say that he's hypocritical, say rather that he's apolitical. Once the rockets go up, who cares where they come down? That's not my department, says Wernher Von Braun. Some have harsh words for this man of renown, but some think our attitude should be one of gratitude, like the widows and cripples of old London town, who owe their large pensions to Wernher Von Braun. You too may be a big hero, once you've learned to count backwards to zero. In German and English, I know how to count down, and I'm learning Chinese, says Wernher Von Braun. When they first launched Explorer into the great beyond, he tried to alleviate when it started to deviate. We had to catch up to those commies somehow. It's a good thing we had lots of Wernher Von Braun. While paperclip was a depravity, what's worse is they lied about gravity. But Von Braun didn't frown and said, this rings a bell, now go fetch me more Germans, und do it mach schnell. At the end of his days, with more time to reflect, he chose to disclose some notions verboten. They planned to deceive us with make-believe threats, and the Cold War was nothing compared to what's next. And after the Russians, it's the terrorists, and then third world countries will be scariest. Soon asteroids become the new enemy, and the best part will be the fake war with E.T. Now when the good OSS took from old Berlin town, they filled us with platitudes as they pillaged each latitude. And Galen told Alan, I've got this one down, we'll tell them the commies just won't come around. So they pretend that we're always at war, there will be nukes like Saddam and Gomorrah. They did it back then, and they'll do it today. Why do you think that they killed JFK? So if you're found by the CIA, don't be alarmed. Just plan your allegiance as they force you into obedience. They'll boil you a bit and pretend that you'll drown, and they'll still get away with it, 'cause you are brown. Some might suggest it's quite comical to claim that it's all just economical. Once they get what they want, who cares what you say, just as long as you say it to the old CIA. They tried to kill Castro a few hundred times. Their coups were quite sinister, just ask the Iranian Prime Minister. And poor Guatemala, how dare you decide to elect your own government? Oh look, your president, he died. Dare I say it's rather rude to stand up for united fruit. They'll just call you commies, and who cares if you're not? Oh, in Cambodia, they helped some dude named Pol Pot. In Syria, they staged a quick coup d'etat. They tried to disarm Indonesia's Sukarno. And Congo's Lumumba, they shot in the face, and they forced out Allende for old Pinochet. They even helped the Dalai Lama, and they ousted Nkrumah in Ghana. Goulart went foobar and probably was killed, but they didn't share the files from that coup in Brazil. They watched Papa Doc and his sweet little babe as they plundered their nation, another CIA creation. And they cooed Vietnam and then still wanted more, so they faked the Gulf of Tonkin to get a new war. The history books are still murky about what happened in Poland and Turkey. And Oliver North, surely he told the truth, but I guess we won't know 'cause he shredded the proof. They armed the Mujahideen to the teeth, yet they still tried to hide. They created Al-Qaeda, and ISIS is simply just more of the same. If you still keep on buying it, you're just insane. Does the fact that it's all still quite classified make you the slightest dissatisfied? Like poor Chavez, so they gave him a cancerous blight. Like Jack Ruby was screwed even though he was right. That they're infecting us with apathetic delight. While the mockingbird sings sweetly, So long, good night.